So, what's the problem? Well, chances are you don't know how to make this texture, or this one. Can't you see the problem? Let's see a simplified case. Anything in particular sound easy? Well, that's what I told myself, until I had to do it.
Sigi, Tao, share your knowledge, grow together.
Let's go back to the simplified example to understand the problem. Here's what you need to see. Two materials are synced to different parts of the geometry. So far, you're going to say to me, hey Rudy, it's easy. Just we make two slots of material. Each slot is assigned to a part of the geometry and basta. Yes, of course. That's what I started doing too. Until I need to add a third material that overlapped the previous two. I started by bugging, before finding an elegant solution that has given rise to a new feature in Materializer. Let me explain. Use only one material. Here are a few words that are far from easy to put into practice. Download the start file to follow me, the links are in the description. Let's start by editing a material in which we are going to request two layers. The first layer will be wood. Simply find the wood pattern in the N panel and connect the color and normal inputs. A small rotation of 90 degrees and a reduction of the normal straight will be enough. For the example. The second layer is our metallic material. The problem is to create a mask to delimit it. Go to Edit Mode and select the geometry to receive the second material. Use the vertex group I've created to select everything with a single click. So just between us, isn't this tutorial well prepared? I could have let you struggle to select everything by hand. I think I'm making life too easy for you. Addons and pre-made files will make you lazy, and I shouldn't be. I hope at least you have subscribed to the channel. Otherwise, next time I will leave you in the lurch. Once you have your selection, switch to vertex paint mode. You can bring up the toolbar by right-clicking and selecting Show Tool Settings. Choose any color, click on the face icon, then Paint, and finally set vertex color. Let's back to our material to exploit what we have just done. Press the F key, then click on Color Mask. This node will give a white mask by searching for the reference color in the colors in the first input. Let's use the Color Attribute node to retrieve the vertex paint result. Looking at the color output of this node, we can find the red we assigned to part of the geometry. Red, which I will use as the reference color for my mask. The output is currently black, as the color picked up from the viewport is not exactly the one we set, and this is due to the viewport transforming the colors. Use the slider until the mask appears and connect the output to the mix layers. And now the magic happens. We can now do what was previously impossible. We are going to be able to add elements that will continuously overlap the previous two. Let's start with a demonstration using a decal. After adding a new mix layer and a new layer, I add a decal. You can see that we have achieved something that would have been much more complicated to do with two material slots. Let's go a step further and add some dirt in the cavities, and you will see the level of intricate materials we can achieve. A new layer based on the rust node using a cavity mask and a grunge for texture gives us an interesting first result. But we are not stopping there. Let's take a look at how you can make your materials even more interesting by mixing masks together. Understand that the level of material intricacy and interaction is key to the credibility of your texture. It's what quickly makes the difference between good and very good object texturing. Without interaction, you can have the best textures in the world, but your object will always appear to be below reality. Because in the real world, nothing is isolated. I'm getting a bit carried away here, but it's a crucial element, and future texturing tutorials will focus on its interactions, which make texturing so realistic. So once again, don't forget to subscribe if you don't want to miss out. So, isn't it nice for a bucket to be textured in 5 minutes? Well, yes, it's nice, but it's also my tutorial, so I'm not going to deny it. Well, here it is, a new tool and a new technique in your toolbox. I will see you soon, and in the meantime, don't forget, we get tired of everything except learning. Bye bye.